Back to the beginning. You. I'm okay. Bombers. They didn't even launch. An attack worth, but I presume because he was in a fleet, wasn't given an attack order. They didn't do anything. A ton of bombers. Royal Guard on defense. Defenders can go to attack with as well. And then instead of ordering a large fleet through, I'm just going to order. Go. Fleet is in again. We're going to do it smart and wait for the eye to appear. Order the 4 ISDs to attack it. See the carnage at the gate already, which is really nice. Ah, yes, that station. You're in trouble now.
You attack that. You attack that. SD1 is in range already anyway. Won't be too long to take it down this. Yes, you can see the bomber's going in this time. And you can hear the missiles going off. It's much better already. It's dead. So that ISD was taken on the eye. Here we go. In the last engagement and died with every one of its bombers still in the hangar, which is kind of annoying. Yeah, you're fine like that. Let's just attack full force against the eye. Yeah, no wonder he crept up on us. The last time we came in straight away and I dealt with this initial area and then went straight after the wharf, and he came in and started beating down on one of our ISD2s. I'd imagine a bunch of the cruisers and corvettes are going to jump in here and get wrecked. But if we can save an ISD2 out of this, that's fine. Small things. There are two K's around as well that usually follow this thing. Going with the ties. This is why I brought the bombers. I want to see what they do against an eye. They can even get their salvo off. Same thing again, I want to get on top. Start taking out turrets. We'll have a bit of a distraction here with the fighters. Just the Xenon having those beam defenses is really annoying. Tears apart TIE fighters. Our defense platform is still under attack. Another wave, they're all redocking, so they're going to be a while before they get to us. Of course, he's attacking us. Victory just jumped in. We have a nice small silhouette though. Bombers are going down already. They are getting their missiles off, that's what we want. In on the side, get all the guns there. Keep him in. Yeah, since we're all having issues today. Are already down, so it's not the biggest of differences, but makes me feel better. Alright, that went a little bit better. Now time for the wharf. Actually, what are you doing in there? Where are the two Ks? Yeah, I found the raider is kind of like, come on. Especially with the fact that all of its weapons are pretty much forward firing. Or have forward firing arcs. Did we wait for the K's? Did we engage the shipyard? Let's try this again. This, there, coordinate attack. Can I move that point? I love that, right? But just for me, they're too close. And I have to wait for everyone else to get into position. No, it's not actually the fighters that I worry about. They're just outside of weapons range. It's the corvettes. As you can see, he hasn't launched all his drones yet. You can see that the corvettes are taking shots already. And then if you trigger too early, then you don't have the firepower from your capital ships. That's the concern. But I will be triggering it early as I did last time. Kind of just want them to start. Ah, look, there it is. That order, and then we're gonna go do do do. Go. So they're gonna attack that, and once we get turned around, we're gonna help the ISD-2 take care of the K. Because I don't want any surprises. Yeah, you guys get in there. The 2Ks. But it's an ISD-2, if it can't handle 2Ks. And out of 2Ks is doing something wrong. It's begun. Do this, get rid of the fighter. The P is down already. That again, and then just attack that. And that ISD's positioning is just terrible. So they are actually targeting the turrets, which is nice. Kind of hoping they target the large turrets on top so we don't lose that ISD. I think I'm gonna go in and do that myself. Half shield. I'm gonna go in and hit those large turrets. I think there's no point in putting carrier command software until the AI can manage a fleet. Which it can't. Hits. Let alone a carrier, it can't handle a fleet, so. Gonna get rid of a few of these. Will help us operate better here. These are the ones up here. This.
That was a bit of a wild shot. Sorry about that.
The other side again. The ISDs actually got rid of the rest of the turrets that were shooting at us. So let's return the favor. No idea how our ISD 2 is going now. Corvette is down.
Not good enough.
Bombers are down. Here, Quentin taking hits. Another bomber down. Worried about any of that. Oh man, you should be dealing with them. Do you like the screeching noise that's been added? But even from this, I have to say that dividing up the fleet has been much better. Okay, yeah, you're going to attack that. We had a repair drone over there for some reason. As these shields are down. That wharf is not going to last too much longer. This guy is focusing on the ISD too, that's fine. Yeah, this might be going a lot better than last time. You're attacking that. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Defense drone. Defense drone.
Don't look at the flag. Please tell me we're not going to get picked apart by defense drones. Definitely TIE fighters here helping us, that's good. See that came melting in the distance. Xenon Wharf is at 12%. Yeah, just from this attack then I would definitely have to say putting everyone into separate groups is much better. Yeah, I still can't handle fleets. just following the blue trails here with no HUD, because our guys don't need blue trails. But they have to be defense drones. Interceptors. Arcton is doing his job. And, I think everything works better in small groups. Squadron of Royal Guard, actually. I'll probably jump into one of the Royal Guard actually after this. And the wharf is down. We're just picking off the defense drones. Excellent. And what, we took out 3 Ks and an I. Didn't lose a single ISD this time. Flight to there.
Get out of here.
Flight to there. Recalling, recalling, recalling. Go. Gate up time. So I rotate and then speed up time. Let everyone get reorganized. Movement. It'll take a minute to get used to. This is right side up. This time we're going to make short work of this ship here. Actually start giving the secondary move orders here now. I'm going to move to there. Speed up time and let things happen. It'll be quicker if we do the thing and go through the gate. Won't worry about that station. Our objective is the ship here in the wharf.
Entering system. Barca's Cascade.
Do this then to get everyone docked up properly and I'm gonna have to wait for that. There we go. See, straight on to the second point.
Entering system matrix number 79B.
The main threats in this system are gone. The eye and the K is gone. It's just a matter of dealing with the stations properly. And now that we have the four ISDs here, it shouldn't be an issue. I imagine another K or two might pop up. ISDs are here. Give him a minute. Everyone set up again. What I'll do is stop them. We're moving orders. Their fighters dock up and do all little things that they have to do. Now actually what I'll do is, where's the harbor? Harbor's gonna sit back there without a fleet. Attack, and the second it launches all its drones will trigger it. like that. Let's pause that real quick. Trigger that, but at the same time, gonna draw once. Kind of hoping they attack the defense drones. Let's see. Wrong button.
You're in for it.
Defense drone.
A lot of defense drones. Don't know how long I'd survive with a HUD. Yeah, the Air Quinton went in really hard.
Defense drone.
I think these lasers got redone again. Able to do much more sustained fire. If they turn around on me, I'm dead. I can't hit. See that we have friendlies in the area. Active friendlies.
Defense drone. Defense drone.
Oh, wait a minute. Did that not trigger? Let me see information. Look at that.
You're finished.
Right, but I think there's a lot more fighters there. You triggered already. Now everyone should be in the fight. The poor ISD-1 was attacking on his own. Their target. The SD-1 is shielding the SD-2.
Defense drone.
Even the Vindicator is still alive this time. Pretty good. Gaggle of TIE fighters up here. Been chased by defense drones. The Victory 2 has been destroyed. Chop here, guys. Yeah, the Victory 2 did get destroyed. Oh. Yeah, these are just going on a rampage.
Hit.
I bet you were. Lost cruiser, all right. Just pure carnage around here with defense drones. I lost a bunch of TIE fighters also, but that station is just getting wrecked.
Xenon shipyard.
This was always our long-term goal, set up the blockade in the first place. Are they clipping through each other? We didn't even lose the dreadnought. We always lose the dreadnought. Blitz like this.
Get off my radar.
The mop-up job now. I just have to destroy these two fabrication areas. Pretty sure all the drones are dead. Yep. So it's a matter of, can our capital ships actually target that? I know they can, and I know it's a pain in the ass for them. We're in the harbor closer. Yeah, he's getting a couple of shots in there, which is good. That looking nice. Yeah. This is gonna be tricky for them to get a firing solution on the fabrication units. This year I still lost a turret. The turrets are now destructible. But for you or me now, that would be directly in sight on those two fabrication units, but whatever way the hitbox is, just doesn't work. There he is, gets shots in now. I'd definitely call that attack a success. I'll have to keep the fleet organization in mind as well for the next campaign. Could not have planned a better flyby there. Do is actually save the game there. Let's let them finish that off, and I want to check. Savage Spur.
Entering system. Savage Spur.
So in the Star Wars mod, the one-way system between Savage Spur 1 and 2 has been changed into is it a highway or a gate? I don't know. It's now two-way, so the Terrans or the Order can now use it to get through. That's why we're losing rep with them, because they're coming through and we're attacking them in the Matrix system. Yeah, there it is. Right, not building anything, that's good. Past the gate there.
Entering system. Matrix number 79B.
Hey Toby, I don't know, man. What do you think? How does it look? First attempt went really badly, to be honest. We got sideswiped by an eye, and lost two of our ISDs in the initial phase. So yeah, initially we came through and I had them all as one big fleet. And you know, the AI just can't handle it. So you started up with it, but someone's going, okay, yeah. This is literally just the one fabrication bay left.
Xenon Shipyard.
We could probably finish that with a fighter. But we had kind of pressed on and did actually destroy the shipyard in the first attempt. But the game froze. So once the game unfroze, we came back in, I separated everything out into separate groups, and it worked so much better that we didn't even lose an ISD. Yeah, they have a couple of shipyards, I suppose. But in this playthrough, this is the new one that's been brought in with Cradle of Humanity. So initially there were shipyard and a wharf for the Xenon here. But actually the Rebel Alliance took that out. And then the Techno Union took the system. We took out the shipyard up here on our little sneak raid with an ISD. We can call that sneaky. And then today we renewed our blockade here and pushed in. So got into a battle with an I and 3Ks here at the wharf. Then moved on over and just wiped out the ship there. Lucky son. It is a victory. All in all, we did that with pretty light losses. Osner, Clinton. Do we fear an attack fleet coming for a fight? No. We've already wiped out their attack fleet. When I was setting up this fleet for the stream, they actually sent in 2Ks and an I here. I didn't notice the I was already dead. And I was just watching the 2Ks fight the station out of system. It was only afterwards I realized that there was an I underneath the station as well. So that had been taken care of before we came into the system. And then we just had to deal with their defense fleet, which is now gone as well. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they have a shipyard in here. And I'm pretty sure they have one here too. Probably down here as well. Oh yeah, and of course they have this whole area. But we're not going to be doing that in this playthrough. I'll be finishing it up here now. This was the main goal. Initially, was to take this. There's been extra stuff added since, so we'll be doing a new playthrough in the coming weeks. Starting fresh. I think they're defenseless but not shipyardless. In this area of the galaxy, they're pretty screwed. So the plan for that is to work with the Order It is kind of going to be an Empire run, kind of. But I was thinking we were going to take a lot more casualties than this, and the whole premise of the new one was going to be that the Republic didn't come and help us, the Empire didn't come and help us, so we're going to get our revenge on them. So the next playthrough will be not attacking the Xenon, but we will be attacking the Republic. We might leave the CSA alone. We'll be attacking the Republic and the Empire. Yeah, exactly. F the Empire and the Rebels. They didn't come and help us when we're throwing our lives on the line against the Xenon. So we're going to use the Order to build up in secret. And then we're going to punch in here against the Rebel Alliance. His Order space will be pretty much here. So I have that started already, where we have a couple of stations just making a little bit of money in the background in Order space. And we'll build up there in the first couple of episodes or streams and so on. And then it'll be all at war. We'll get our economy going up so that it can keep up with the war. Exactly, with a couple of secret backers in the Order that were helping us out. They're setting us up with a couple of stations to get our economy rolling. The premise of the next campaign. We won't worry about the Xenon at all. What I might do is another day I might just send this fleet into Savage Spur and get a couple of shots of it getting destroyed or something like that. Because I want to make a little cinematic video of between the two campaigns. Oh, lucky I saved, because the game is frozen again. So let's start the stream with the stations already, or start from scratch. I'm going to start the stream with the stations because I don't want it to be 10 to 20 hours of getting the economy up. Yeah, X4 has crashed again. So yeah, probably going to leave that there, guys. I appreciate everyone hanging out. Hope you're having a good weekend. Now, hopefully I'll catch you next time. We'll be doing a stream tomorrow, starting earlier than usual.